it seemed to suggest that God takes his chair and sits in our praise. So music invites God. Music does not only invite demons, it also invites God, depending on whom you are singing to. If you are following, let me hear you say amen.
Amen.
Music is important. Music is important. Just in case you have some doubts, let me show you where music drove away demons. Where music drove away demons. 1 Samuel 16, verse number 22. Talking about Saul, after he was tormented by an evil spirit, it says, "And it came to pass, when the evil spirit from God was upon Saul, that David took a harp and played with his hand, so Saul was refreshed and was well, and the evil spirit departed." Expect the evil spirit to depart this afternoon, amen? Hello? We didn't just come here to have a good time. We came here to chase away devils. Amen.
Amen.
Music matters because when we are singing godly music, the devil runs away. Amen.
Amen.
And I think I have already seen some of it happening. Some people are sitting down that I've never seen them sitting down in church. That's good. I have one more. Two more for you. Daniel 3, verse number 15. Music involved also in apostasy. Now when you hear the sound of the horn, the flute, the zither, and the lyre, the harp, the pipe, and all kinds of music, if you are ready, fall down and worship the image I have made. Very good. But if you don't worship it, you'll be thrown immediately into a blazing furnace. Then what God will be able to rescue you from my hand? We see music involved in a call to apostasy. Even when Moses came down from the mount and the children of Israel had made a golden calf, they were singing music. Music has the power to invite God, and it also has the power to invite the devil. It has the power to chase him away also, depending on what kind and how we are presenting that music. Music is powerful. Music matters. Amen. I will show you one more and then we will go back to the singing. 2 Chronicles 20, verse number 22. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse number 22. Music, the only thing created in heaven that we enjoy here on earth. 2 Chronicles 20, verse number 22. When they began singing and praising, the Lord set ambushes against the sons of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir, who had come against Judah, so they were routed. And this is the story of a king who decides that since the enemy has come that he has no control of, and since the problem he is facing is bigger than him and is bigger than any problem he's ever known, he decides, after consulting God, that he will sing praises to God. And the text we've just read, it says, when they began to sing and to praise, the Lord started moving. The Lord set ambushes. The verse seems to suggest that God did not set the ambushes until they started praising. God will ambush your enemy when you get to praise mode. Amen? God will deal with the enemy that has come to destroy you if we will praise him in song. My prayer for you is this afternoon, as the groups are singing, you also may join in the singing. My prayer for you this afternoon is you receive not just entertainment, but you receive deliverance from your enemy. Deliverance from demons, because music is powerful. Music activates the spiritual. Music is one of those things that started off in heaven that we are enjoying right now. We don't fully understand, but we do know that when we sing praises to God, God inhabits our praise. When we sing, as David sang, demons run away. And so music is important. As, again, I emphasize, as we enjoy the music, let it be worship for you. Let it be you inviting God into your heart. Let it be a prayer that is asking God to ambush the enemy of souls. Let it, the music be you connecting with Jehovah. May God bless you. We have received prayer cards. I'm going to ask you to write your name and your phone number there, if you may. But I'm going to ask you to do something very special. At the back of that prayer card, I want you to write your prayer request. Write your prayer request at the back of that prayer card. And we are going to take time, if you notice, we have a music and prayer session on the program. We're going to take time to make sure that the enemy is ambushed. We have pens available. If you don't have a pen, ushers, you can see the hands of those who don't have pens. Anyone who needs a pen? There's a hand over here. Sister Diane, Sister Putri. Pens. A hand over there. Anyone else who needs a pen? Okay, right at the back. Please provide our sister and our brother at the back with a pen. If you also don't have the card, anyone who doesn't have the prayer card? Anyone who doesn't have the prayer card? Okay, if you need the prayer card, just wave your hand and someone will bring it to you. It's going to be a musical afternoon with a difference. It's the kind of afternoon that the devil hates. Prayerless singing is useless, but when we sing and pray, wow, what a power. Music matters. God bless you.
Okay, so for our second session of praises, we have...
We're going to start off with Carolyn Kellen,
David Lintong,
Rotwa Damayanti Hotosoe. Did I say that right?
Hotosoe. Tiffany Larry.
Jehovah Jireh House of Fellowship.
And Chris Duck Mayo. May we all be blessed.
Soothe me. watching eyes, he asked me why I walk this narrow way. I will gladly give the reason for the hope I have today.
A little help, God knows.
This is not temporary hope.
Just a quick announcement regarding the prayer card. Please keep the prayer cards until towards the end of the program, as we will be having our prayer session with Pastor Tendai, and then cards will be collected afterwards.
I thank God for my love. tossed to and fro. When you're faced with life's decision, you're not sure which way to go. Stand still and let God move. Standing still, it's hard to do.
the song that we want to sing right now is the familiar song in the Adventist Church. So we want to invite you to sing together with us in the first refrain, Because He Lives.
Tomorrow, because
Wow, what a powerful Sabbath afternoon indeed.
Yeah.
Okay, so at this moment, we'll have our prayer session. So we'd like to invite.
We'd like to call in Pastor Tendai Timory for our prayer session.
Good afternoon once again, everyone. We praise the Lord for the opportunity to praise Him and sing songs in His name. We are going to do more than sing, as I told you. We are going to push the devil out, and we are going to win victories in the name of Jesus this afternoon. Amen. So I know some came for different reasons. Some came to meet with Jesus. Some came to praise God, but some came to meet friends. But you're going to get a bonus. You will leave here and your burdens will stay at Calvary. Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to ask you to just pick three people and pray with them. Three people, share a prayer request with them, and let's get into a season of prayer together. Any three people, try to pray with somebody you haven't prayed with before. Your time is now. Pick three people. You can go to a corner, you can stand anywhere with those three. This place is a place of prayer. I'm encouraging that you do three so the prayers won't be so long. Okay, so don't do six or seven or eight. Three, I hope you all can count.
Prayer request.
Praise the Lord. We are going to have testimony time soon. So if you've been dying to just publicly thank Jesus for what he's been doing in your life, get prepared. We're going to give you a chance to do that. I'm going to ask for all ordained elders. If there's any ordained elders in the house, please come forward. Just join me here on stage. If you are ordained elder in your church or school, wherever you are ordained, please come forward. Let me see if there's any ordained deacon. Any deacon? Just wave your hand if you're ordained a deacon. I know you're there. Okay? Thank you, Brother Roy. Please come. Come on, there should be more. Anyone else ordained as a deacon? All right, thank you. Please join me on stage. Doesn't matter which church you're from, as long as you're ordained and elder deacon, please come. We are going to push. We're going to pray until something happens. We pushed one in threes. Now we're going to push again. I'm going to ask for all those who have prayer requests that have to do with career and business to meet in that corner over there with Elder Rodney. That corner? That's career and business. You're going to pray for that in that corner. All right. I'm going to pray for all those who have requests that have to do with marriage and courtship, etc., etc., to meet with me in that corner over there. All right? All right. I'm going to ask all those. In fact, I'll ask you to meet with Batara in that corner over there, because he specializes in praying for that. Don't worry about it. Batara, marriage and courtship, you married, right?
Yes.
Okay, good, good. You know what it's about. You can pray for it. That corner over there, you can go to your corner. Go ahead, go to your corner. Thank you. All right. Those whose prayer requests are for spiritual issues, okay? Spiritual issues and disease. I'm going to ask you to join me up here on stage. Okay? Those are the three groups we're going to pray together for. One, career and business, money-related issues, go to Elder Rodney, that corner over there. Those praying for relationships, marriage, dating, courtship, go see Batara over there. And then those who are praying for health concerns and spiritual issues, come see me up front here, and we're going to pray together. Those are the three groups we will pray in right now.
Hey, happy Sabbath! Wow! Puji Tuhan!
Welcome!
Berarti next time gue yang ke Jizdak ya?
Iya!
Aku masih ke Jizdak ya? Puji Tuhan!
Permisi.
Semakin spiritual didoakan semakin datang nanti.
Amin, sister.
Yang penting kan
spiritual. Valerie, lihat belakang kamu ada apa?
Ada.
Nanti kita pegangannya di sini aja.
Don't be shy to go for courtship prayer, okay? You might miss out on your blessing as well. We want to pray for spiritual and health. That's what we want to pray for. If there is a prayer that you will notice in the Bible, God never delayed to answer, it was a prayer for spiritual health. God never ever delayed to say 4 days later, I'll come and forgive your sin or help deliver you from sin or evil. So if there's a prayer that Jesus wants to answer, it's this one here. Amen?
Amen.
For this purpose, the Son of God was made manifest. That's 1 John 3. So that he might destroy the works of the devil. So this circle is one of those circles that Jesus actually specializes in helping us spiritually. Okay. And I have mentioned, I've asked those who have physical concerns to join this group, because physical healing starts with the inside. Physical healing starts with spiritual healing. Paul writing says, "Beloved, I wish above all things that you prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospers." As the soul is prospering, as you are prospering spiritually, he wishes us to be also in good health. I never get tired of reminding us that oftentimes when Jesus healed the sick, he said, "Thy sins are forgiven." Oftentimes when you'll be healing the sick, you say, "Thy sins are forgiven," and they'll be healed. So as we pray for what is spiritual, let's pray. We will also be praying for the physical ailments. Anyone who wants to share prayer requests? Who wants to go first? Hurry up, no time to be shy. We have to go back to the singing, yes? All right, what's your request?
So what is your request?
Who has a prayer request to share?
One.
Waiting for who will go first, yes? Somebody go first, please. Now, please, someone go first. Please go first.
Go first.
Okay, go for it. Yes, sister. I'm praying for my vision. I get the third vision since I had a brain surgery. And my nose was really awesome. Okay, do you believe God can heal? Okay, let's pray for our sister's vision. She can't see clearly ever since she had her surgery. Okay, let's pray for her. Anyone else? Yes. Let's pray for our sister, and I know her request is not, she's not alone in this one, struggling to keep the Sabbath holy, okay? Not just to keep the day, but to actually bathe in the presence of God on Sabbath, yes? Okay, we'll pray for that one. Anyone else? Yes. Her family to know more about Jesus. Just so you know, Inda is coming from the Muslim background. Okay? She's been coming with us. She's been with us for about a month now. Let's pray for her family. Anyone else? Don't miss this opportunity. A place of prayer like this, and you go home with your burdens, it's your loss. It's your loss. Who else has a prayer request? Taking mud and putting it on his eyes. Do you remember that story? If you don't know any better, you might just collect the mud thinking that there's something special about the mud. Right? Think, oh, maybe there's some nutrients or minerals in the mud that open blind, open eyes of the blind. But it wasn't the mud. What was it? Why did it work? Why did it work? Faith. Yes. It works because God says it works. Yeah. The tree in the garden. The tree of life.
You only come up with me, baby.
Praises to you. We know you are in this place. We take time to cry to you before God. Because we believe you are the Lord who heals all our diseases.
God is to come with you and everything else will follow. And Father, please pray for each and every one of them. They will find the right partner that you have prepared for them. They will find the right one, the one who can grow spiritual with them and who can take the journey with them towards you, Father. And we thank you, Father, for hearing and answering our prayers. And this prayer will be for you.
It still seems to emphasize and remind that Jesus is the same. The same Jesus who walked in Galilee, the same Jesus who raised the dead, the same Jesus today. And so we ask you on behalf of our sister, who needs you to open her eyes? Yes, the surgery has taken place. Yes, the doctors have what they have to say, but you are God, and all things are possible with you. If you want, you can touch her. If you want, snap your fingers. If you want, and I believe you want, Lord, if thou wilt, Lord, you can restore her sight. And the end of it all, what we desire. And I know that what she wants is that your name will be glorified. And so, if your name will be glorified, when her receiving the sight,
Bapa kami yang bertata dalam kemuliaan kerajaan surga, Bapa yang kami sembah siang dan malam. Di saat ini, kami semua sangat bersyukur dapat berkomunikasi dengan Engkau.
I thank you, Lord, for the faith of those who are willing to say, here I am, Lord, this is my story, please heal me. I do know, Lord, that there are some who are suffering quietly, who have not dared to mention it. And yet, Lord, I pray for mercy for them as well. That while on others you are calling, please do not pass them by. I pray because we all have a disease that is worse than any blindness, worse than any cancer, worse than any diabetes. It is the spiritual disease. We have sin that seeks all. Kneeling with me, Lord, are young men and young women who need deliverance from pornography, Lord. The devil has been whipping them left, right, and center because of the computer, their phones, and the internet. Deliver us today from the powers of darkness. Today, Lord, we want to leave this place saying our victory in Jesus, our Savior. We never want to go back to that old life again. We want to be able to say thanks be to God who gives us the victory over pornography, over masturbation, over lust, over backbiting and gossip. Lord, your deliverance is real. Your power is real. You are able to save to the uttermost those who come to you asking for help. I pray, Lord, for not only those who are struggling with the diseases of
dan kiranya kami juga tidak menjadi orang yang cinta diri. Setelah Engkau memberikan berkat lewat bisnis kami, biarlah kami juga dapat menyalurkan berkat-berkat itu dengan baik dan benar, terutama di dalam menopang akan kerja Tuhan di mana saja kami berada. Terima kasih Bapa, inilah doa dan permohonan kami.
Dear gracious Heavenly Father, we come to you today, Lord, to pray to worship you. We pray, we have a specific prayer that we might be the kind of people who always want us to be of the
best of the people who are already married and have kids. Lord, it's not easy. Marriage is just a journey that is going to be discovered every single day, especially those people, especially Kak Janet, myself, and Batara, who has kids. Kids, they are from you, Lord. And our responsibility, Lord, is to take care of them and for them to know you, Lord. And there are certain things that sometimes we can't even do. It's only you, Lord, that is going to bring them up to be someone who love you as well, Lord. And we know that the end is coming. And we need to implement all these things, Lord, before God comes. and we want them to be in heaven with us. So dear Heavenly Father, give us the Spirit.
For many of us are locked down by the enemy of soul because we have grudges and hatred and unforgiveness in our hearts. There are people who abused us when we were children, and up to this day we hate them and we haven't forgiven them, and it's hurting us. It's hurting our spiritual life. Today, Lord, give us hearts like yours. Hearts that will forgive, Lord. Hearts that will let go and leave vengeance to you. Hearts that will be free, because you said when the Son sets you free, you are free indeed. We pray, Lord, that we might be able to forgive as you have forgiven us. Let mercy ooze out of us. May we talk mercy. May we walk mercy. May we show that the grace of God that has appeared to us and we have enjoyed is the grace we are showing to others. We thank you, Heavenly Father. There are many other things I have not mentioned in specificity, but you know it all, and we simply kneel today and say, Lord, meet us at this point of need. We refuse to leave BNI 46 today, the same people who came here. We refuse to bring our burdens here and go home with our burdens. Change us, transform us, because your power is real. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Are you blessed? Can I see your hands? We're blessed by the prayer session that we just had. For now, we are going to have our fellowship break. Snacks and drinks are provided at the back, so you may serve yourselves, and we'll be back in 15 minutes. Sorry, 10 minutes. So we will have our fellowship break for 10 minutes. So yes, please serve yourself. It's at the back.
So, how are we doing?
Yeah, good. Great.
You are in good time?
Yeah, we're perfect. Oh, we're perfect. So we have done some practice and no more prayer session because it's done already. Just some prayer session, right? Okay, so we only have one testimony, which is Jimmy's. Yeah?
Probably.
Thanks.
Hello everyone. We only have 5 minutes to grab our snack because our sound system will be available until 6:30. Thank you. 5 minutes. Thank you.
Di sini, di dekat sini, makanya. Di perlu enak. Kamu yang pianis.
Parah banget, umpah. And Jehovah Jireh, House of Worship. May we all be blessed. So may we have everyone, invite everyone to go back to their seat. As we are going to start with our third session of praises, again, we invite everyone to go back to their seat. Thank you very much. Jehovah Jireh House of Worship.
Hello, happy Sabbath. We're glad to be here. Thank you for having us. Yes. Okay. Pastor just told me wait until they sit down. Okay, we invite all of the people that are still in the back, please take your seat.
Yes, please, as we're going to start, just bring the snacks over to your seat so that we can start our program. And we can continue, we can continue with our program. Thank you.
Okay, we are the Gumba Klabat. I would like to say thank you for Brother Roy for inviting us to share our music here in the last minute also. But we're going to sing a number that is based on the Revelation 21, verse 2. The whole chapter is talking about the beautiful city that John envisioned. John had vision about the beautiful city, and he felt as if he is walking in that beautiful city, which is Jerusalem. The title of the song is Walk in Jerusalem.
I want to be ready, I want to be ready, I want to be ready to walk in Jerusalem just like John. I want to be ready, I want to be ready, I want to be ready to walk in Jerusalem just like John.
Oh John, how didn't you say,
walk in Jerusalem just like John,
that you'll be there on that great day.
Walk in Jerusalem just like John. I want to be ready, I want to be ready, I want to be ready to walk in Jerusalem just like John. I want to be ready, I want to be ready, I want to be ready to walk in Jerusalem just like John.
King Jesus rides in the middle of the air,
walk in Jerusalem just like John.
I'll pray the Lord will all be there,
walk in Jerusalem just like John. I want to be ready, I want to be ready, I want to be ready to walk in Jerusalem.
Great day,
the righteous marching.
Great
day, walk in Jerusalem just like John.
Oh, I want to walk
in Jerusalem just like John.
Walk
in Jerusalem just like John.
Walk
in Jerusalem,
walk
in Jerusalem just like John.
I want to walk
in Jerusalem just like John.
I want to walk
in Jerusalem just like John.
Walk
in Jerusalem,
walk
in Jerusalem just like John.
Walk
in Jerusalem just like John.
In
Jerusalem just like John. In Jerusalem, in Jerusalem just like John.
I want to walk
in Jerusalem just like John.
In
Jerusalem just like John. In Jerusalem, in Jerusalem just like,
walk in Jerusalem just like,
just like John.
Okay.
Have you ever felt like you feel you pray alone, you know? When life gets too tough and you seem like you just cannot trust someone. But through this song, we learn that actually we never pray alone. Yes, you find a way through the life you make. I hope you live each day for all it's worth. Go where your conscience leads and dream your biggest dreams. All of these things I will pray for you. And it hurts so much.
we do apologize at this time because Grandma Klamat have limited stock song in English. But no worry, Alvin will translate it.
Okay, so our next song is a familiar hymn. The title is "He Keeps Me Singing." There's within my heart a melody song, yeah, but in Bahasa. Okay.
Narani dari hatiku, bisikannya yang merdu. Bersama Yesus damai selalu mengalir sepanjang waktu. Yesus, 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 indah namanya. Biarlah ku bernyanyi sukacita selamanya. Nada yang indah di hatiku,
di hatiku,
di hatiku,
di hatiku,
merdu. Ramadhan memberiku gembira, tiap saat ku dijaga. Bila pandang wajah kasihnya, bersorak puji dia. Yesus, 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 indah namanya. Biarlah ku bernyanyi sukacita selamanya. Segera Yesus akan kembali, jemput kita ke surga. Bahagia tentram dan abadi di surga bersama. Yesus, Yesus, indah namanya. Biarlah ku bernyanyi sukacita selamanya, sukacita selamanya, sukacita selamanya.
Starting off with Tiffany Wari,
David Lintong,
Jehovah Jireh House of Worship,
Maria Nainggolan,
Praise Dark Vocal Group,
and the Seventh Quartet.
Thank you. Singing is a privilege, and we would like to support your effort in bringing music to be an important part of your worship service. And the seven singers, we strive to give best music for God, and it's not what we want, but what God wants, and that's the most important thing.
Amen.
May you be blessed by the song we are giving.
Ooh.
carry the weight of the world upon his shoulders. I know my brother that he will carry you. Oh, if he carried the weight of the world upon his shoulders, I know my sister that he will carry you. He said, come unto me, all who are weary and I will give you
at his nails-scarred feet. He cares so much for me. There's no one cares who cares.
Everything I need is in you.
decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. To follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning back.
In the things familiar, we find security. Resisting all the changes that days and years can bring. When God decides to lead you through an open door, inviting you to walk in realms you've never known before. Beyond the open door is a new and fresh anointing. Hear the Spirit calling you to go. Walk on through the door, for the Lord will call before you
into a greater power.
You
Jesus, who cry out for living.
is like today.
It has been a blessed day indeed, and we are now at the end of our program.
Before we formally end our program this evening, let me call on Jehovah Jireh for their closing instrumental, closing song. As the song is being played, our deacons are ready to collect the offering.
Another important announcement, actually we are serving you dinner. It'll be on the other side of the room. So after the program, we invite everyone to join us and have our dinner in the other room. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. yes.
Before we're going to pray for closing prayer and prayer for dinner. We have a long list to thank because we're so blessed this Sabbath up to this sundown. We want to thank Sarah, Roberto, and Elizabeth Hernandez for because they've been entertaining the kids, not just entertaining, but educating them in Bible and in fun through their program of Kids Vacation Bible Camp. Hopefully, Indonesia will have this Vacation Bible Camp for kids starting from next year. Let's pray about it because it's very, very, very good for the kids. And we would like also to thank Maureen Tombokan and April Rigos, our MCs, our blessed MCs. And then we have special guests starting from this morning, all the way from BSD, Jehovah Jireh, House of Worship. Thank you so much for coming. We have also Ben Hill Quartet and Prisma SDA Church Groups. Thank you very much for coming. And we have dearest Maria Nengolan. Thank you. Carolyn Kellen, which is sort of getting out. And Rotua Damayanti Utasoit. Where is she? Thank you so much. And Olga Situmorang, David Lintong and Tiffany Wari, our youngest singers. And Gemak Labat and the Seventh Quartet. Thank you all very, very much. God bless you. And I hope you are all blessed just like how we've been feeling. Okay.
All right, so on behalf of the Upper Room Ministry, we thank you for your presence. And since we're running out of time, I was gonna tell us a little bit about the ministry, but then you can look it up on our website. You are ursda.com on our Facebook Upper Room Center. We can always if you guys didn't get that, we can always have a chat later, and we hope to have a partnership with you guys in the ministry some in the future. Thank you so much. Thanks for coming.
Yeah. And last but not least, we have also another presence of another pastor, Pastor Daud from Prisma SDA Church. Thank you very much for coming, Pastor. Papan.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for bringing all the team here. Thank you. So now we would like to call Meryl, our friend Meryl Malinti, to deliver closing prayer and prayer for dinner.
And all the things we have learned. Thank you, Lord, for all the joy you bring and our wonderful times together. May we walk with you as each new day begins. Father, you are mighty and strong to sustain our body. We thank you for the meal we are about to enjoy. Please bless the food so it can nourish our bodies and we can be used by you more effectively. Amen. Thank you, Lord, for yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forevermore. Amen. Amen.
Happy working week, everybody. Let's proceed to the other room to have dinner. You are all welcome and obligated. Thank you.
Let's do this again.
Oh yeah, see you in our next afternoon of worship.
Thank you very much. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you.
Well done, good job.
Mati, same to you.
No, gak makan kalian. Mau dinner.
Yes.
thank you udah pinjamin Moren.
Ini kayaknya harus punya deh. Tadi bukan di situ, tapi di kursi.